So this is a project that comes from, well, actually, let me introduce myself first. My name's Sam Betts. Hi, everyone. I'm a cloud solution architect based in Madrid. And yeah, this project comes from a bunch of customer feedback that we got on how to rate Copilot in terms of value. For a couple of different reasons, right? So, the first question is always, who should we onboard to Copilot? The paid one, especially. As you know, there's two versions of Copilot. You've got your free one, and then the more advanced paid one. A lot of customers have asked, you know, how do I identify who should be on the paid, etc. And this is what this project tries to answer, and I'll show you how. Essentially, what we are doing is identifying groups of users that are using Office quite intensely, and then we're using their usage data as a justification for going full Copilot. Because we've got customers who have a lot of frontline workers, for example. They just use Teams chat, probably wouldn't benefit from, you know, the full functionality. And then we've got other users who are very intensely using Office, Teams meetings, this kind of thing. And it's all about based on, you know, usage data, hard numbers, if you like, grouping them up by demographics, and then saying these people should have the full thing. That's kind of the first step. And then once they have it, how do we know that they are getting the full value out of it? Well, they like it, they are more productive, and so on. So that's the kind of thesis of this project. Now, a lot of people have also asked, where does this fit in terms of the Copilot dashboard that you may have seen? It fits in terms of the first part, which is, who do we put onto Copilot and why? So there's a pretty big hole there right now. There are usage reports, but they're fairly basic as they stand out the box. And then in the Copilot dashboard, there's a section on impact. In fact, I think I have it up somewhere. Do I? Do I indeed? No, I don't. You may have seen it. A second. Copilot dashboard. It's part of Viva Insights now. So come on, where is it? Here it is. So there's a section here on impact of Copilot once it's deployed. And this is a nice out-of-the-box report in Viva Insights. And in fact, the Value Analytics project can even feed into this dashboard here. So it works kind of in side-by-side. So that's where it fits in. Onboarding then. Essentially what we do is look at a whole bunch of usage stats from, you know, all across M365, even Copilot now as well. We have some customers who have rolled out Copilot chat, and they want to know specifically who is using Copilot chat in a way that they should have the full one. So I don't know if you've seen, you can upload files to Copilot chat. You can just in the chat window say, what do you think of this file? You know, and actually what it does is upload it to a space in your OneDrive and then does a kind of analysis anyway there. But if they're doing that a lot, then they're prime candidates to get the full version. So that is now surfacing as a number of files uploaded to Copilot chat. But that plus a whole bunch of stuff, which we then cross with user attributes that we also read in from Enter ID to then get our most likely users that will benefit from Copilot. All right, so this isn't, us coming and saying, just everyone get Copilot. Yay. This is us saying, here's why these people should have Copilot. You know, so a bit more of a data-based migration strategy, if you like. So this is essentially how it works. I may just jump into demo at this point. Let me perhaps show you the back end briefly. First of all, the project itself is here. It's on our PMP repository. So it's all open source. There's a couple of intro bits and pieces. There's a full setup guide here, plus a bunch of prerequisites as well. So it's all there. Once you run the setup, you'll end up with a bunch of stuff in Azure. It doesn't take too long to stand up. I won't do it live, but we're talking in the region of like half an hour tops, something like that. And then we end up with this being our kind of crown jewels of it, a SQL database with all of the usage stuff stored in one nice handy location that we can do all sorts of interesting queries on. Now, the interesting stuff, or the pretty stuff, if you like, is all done in Power BI here. This is essentially, it's a test environment, hence we don't get too much data going on here. But here is where I'm going to define my criteria for who is an active user. So I'm going to say people that have certainly been active in emails, also editing and viewing files, a whole bunch of stuff that I can say would make a heavy user of Office. Now, as you can see, there's not many users that reach that because this is a test environment. This has been deployed, by the way, to quite a few, I'll say, a decent number of large customers, at least in Spain. So this does work. Now, we can also filter by license, by job title, department, a whole bunch of stuff, which by default comes from Enter ID, but we can also bring in from outside, being that this is Power BI and awesome like that. And essentially, once we've built up our criteria of what a active user is, we can even split that. At the moment it's on department and then email, but I could add another layer in, so country and then department. Hang on a sec. Let me do that, for example. So we're doing, Switzerland, country, and then department. Again, in this case, it's not particularly interesting results because of the data set. But once I have my criteria set up, then it is a case of going here and exporting that to Excel, being that these people or this group do lots of stuff. Let's get them on Copilot. So that's kind of step one. We want to be able to justify our business case here, rather than just, migrating random people to Copilot. All right. Step two, or the second part, is how do we know it's any good once it's deployed? I mean, this is for a couple of reasons. Like, A, is it worth the money? And B, maybe there's a training issue and we need to look at how we, ramp up users. All of these things are obviously concerns once it's deployed, but essentially we want to justify the money that's being paid for it. Now, this is a bit more technical, so I'm going to jump into Teams here. All right. So essentially what we have is a bot, which, as you can see, is actually, I think this is the bot. Yeah. I have a feedback bot here. Let me make it a bit bigger. It knows, essentially the system knows when I've done something with Copilot, specifically around like files and meetings and so on. And it just wants to know how my experience was with this specific interaction. Okay, this is automatic. The system knows when you've done something with a file or a meeting in this case. By the way, this is all just from the audit log, in case you're wondering where this information comes from. We just import that data. So I edited this file. How was that then? Yes, I remember that was brilliant. Couldn't have been any more useful. Bot's very happy, as you can see. Now, there's some extra info here that I can, if I want, as a user, provide. By the way, I can just tell the bot to go away and just never bother me again if I hate this kind of thing, which you may do. But there's some extra stuff here that I can fill out, which is customizable. In this case, I've got just a couple of basic questions. And the bot says, thank you very much, and will probably ping me again tomorrow, if I don't say otherwise, about some more stuff that I've done with Copilot. Now, all of this is so that when we go to, when us as the administrators want to see how our, you know, users are handling Copilot, we can see based on our KPIs, are what's important to us, how users are actually getting on with Copilot. So how many, like here, for example, the report for this bit is not particularly advanced yet, but the most positive question is, how many minutes has Copilot saved you? Actually can't see the response right now, but as in progress. We can see that in general, apparently people don't like Copilot based on the questions that we've set up. So let me have a quick look at that. We can see here the questions that I've actually defined, the follow-up questions. Here's an adaptive card that the bot will send. And then the questions that kind of get tagged onto the end. So it's like, how many minutes has Copilot saved you? For some reason, the optimal value is zero. doesn't seem like a particularly optimal value to me. I would probably say greater than zero. But what you can see here is I can build up a series of questions that are important to me in terms of what I feel Copilot should be good at, right? And then the bot will simply answer that the next time it sends out a survey. And I can see... somewhere. What based on that setup, whether or not that's a good or a bad answer. So, yeah. So this is like your own feedback on your own terms, essentially, right? Not on Microsoft terms or anything like that. Last bit. If I've got a couple of minutes. There's another Power BI that comes with out the box.
You'll have a few minutes. Can you put this window in a full screen mode, because it's better in the recording. Excellent. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry, it looks big to me. So, yeah. All right. There's a report here that basically gives you an overview of what's going on. We can see what sort of interactions we are having. Filter again by department or any other metric that we like. Our ratings, so, you know, overall, what are the users saying about overall satisfaction, what sort of activity they're doing, and we can sort of see that by type of activity or again by one of our demographics. And there is a section on time saved as a sort of bolt-on question, so, you know, what do users feel like they're saving, and we can quantify that as well. So there we go. Again, this is a solution that is in use right now. Some customers just want the onboarding stuff, which is fine. Other customers are interested in more follow-up questions as well. It's a tool to to justify your Copilot with hard numbers. There we go. Can't say it any clearer than that.